Let me start the recording. Okay. Hi team, good evening. Recording has been started. Okay. So let's see today's objective. So today we will try to finish the pipes, basically filters and services concept, injectables basically. Why we need, what is service, why we need it, how we do it. Correct? Similarly, what are pipes, correct? Why we use it, how we use it. So we'll see pipe first, then services, okay? So what I do is I'll take one sample project. I have a banner component there. I have menu component there. So let me just comment these two. Let me add one more component. I say filter, pipe filter. Pipe filter, NGG pipe filter, okay? NGG C, sorry, C stand for component. Okay, I have opened the PowerShell basically in the command terminal. Switches to CMD. Component pipe filter. My mistake again, my mistake. We are in wrong folder. Let me close this. Open the terminal again. Now we are good. Now we are inside the project. Just 1 minute. Team. Okay, so we are into basic component project. Yep, you can see the component is created, right? Pipe filter. And what we do to make it run, any idea? Isko kaam karne ke liye, isko chalane ke liye, what we should do, team? Kya karu aisa ki work kare?
Initialize it in app component.html.
Speak little louder. Is my voice audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so tell me what I should do to make it work.
So inside this connector over the app component.html.
all this into app component question. Do you all agree? Do you all agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's start then. When I say pipe filter, what is pipe filter? Pipe filter is also it is also inbuilt functionality. Your directive is also inbuilt functionality, right? If you need looping, you have ng for directive. If you need click event, you have click directive. If you need, you know, if else control statement, you have ng if else directive. For everything you have an inbuilt function, right? And now we say pipes are also the inbuilt functionality only. We don't create it, it's already there. Yes, we can create it, but we don't create it if it is not required, because it is already there. The point is, what are pipe filters? For example, you wanted to change the date format, you need a filter, you need pipe basically. You wanted to change the currency, correct? You need basically pipe filter, correct? You need pipes basically. You want to convert the case of the letter or the word, right? You want to print it in uppercase, lowercase, title case. Right, date change, date format change, currency format change. For all the functionality, you already have an inbuilt pipe. Now my question is, directive are also which are something have inbuilt functionality. Pipes are also having inbuilt functionality. So what is the change that you see? The difference kya hai dono mein? LVT, क्या डिफरेंस लगता है तुम्हारे को? If both talks about the inbuilt functionality, the difference क्या दोनों में? Hello?
No idea.
No idea?
Yes, sir.
Anyone? Okay. जो डायरेक्टिव्स होते हैं, डायरेक्टिव्स बेसिकली डू द डोम मैनिपुलेशन. वो दे प्ले ऑन एलिमेंट्स बेसिकली, करेक्ट? दे प्ले ऑन एलिमेंट्स. जैसे अब क्लिक डायरेक्टिव है, क्लिक डायरेक्टिव बेसिकली वर्क्स ऑन क्लिक बिहेवियर, क्लिक फंक्शनलिटी, ऑन क्लिक फंक्शनलिटी. आपका एन जी फॉर है, राइट? दैट प्लेज विद डू फंक्शनलिटी एंड जनरेट एलिमेंट्स डायनेमिकली, करेक्ट? They change the structure basically, the directive, right? They introduce, they inject their functionality, and they edit the DOM, they manipulate the DOM, they play with DOM. DOM is document object model, in short, your HTML page. Did you understand this or not? If you, yes, apply ng if, so ng if will make sure if the condition satisfied, then only it will apply. Otherwise, that element will not be loaded in the DOM. It will not be available. So DOM manipulation means your HTML, page and manipulation on the fly dynamically. That is what your directive does. Like there is a directive called ng class. So you can apply the classes dynamically. You can apply the styles dynamically with the help of ng style. So what they are doing? They are changing the DOM. They are manipulating the DOM. Again, what is DOM? Document object model. What is document object model? The page which loads in your browser, correct? That is your DOM. The page which loads in your browser is called DOM. Tim, is it clear to all of you about directive?
Yes, sir.
All of you? Or only one?
Yes, sir.
Now, how, yes, pipes are different? How pipes are different? Pipe works on pipe or filter, whatever you can call it, right? As I said, changing from lowercase to uppercase, uppercase to lowercase, title case, right? Then you're filtering.
What else we have in inbuilt pipe? Date change, date format change, currency format, number format change, currency format change. So pipe are the one which basically changes the data. They transform the data, not the DOM structure. They work on data. Is that clear or not? Directives work on the DOM manipulation. Directive work on the structural changes. Correct? Your pipes work on data transformation or data change. Is that clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Any question? Any question? No? Okay. Let's jump on the implementation. Okay. Let's jump on the implementation. Now, I'll start with the cases, basically. Upper case, lower case, title case, right? I'm creating a name, the string type, right? And in the constructor, I am passing the values of this dot name. First to Ajay Shankar. Okay, Ajay Shankar. Now, what I do is, with the help of property binding, this is open closed, and I say name, simple property binding, correct? No pipe associated with it. Let me just parallelly run also on this project as well. ONG so let it generate, let it run. Yeah. So on localhost 35,962, it is running. Okay. Let's hit this. Yeah, so you can see Ajay Shankar is printed. Obviously, no change. This is what we binded, and it is exactly what it has printed. So no change. Now we apply pipe. And to apply pipe, what we need to do is we just simply say pipe operator, and I will say uppercase, save. See, the name has been printed in uppercase. Let's try to use title case. See, title case means first letter of every word should be in capital. So title case. Is that clear so far?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any doubt, any question? So this is pipe. This is okay. Let's see date format.
I have a date. I say it is of date type. Is dot. Equals to new. I print this today, correct? It will print me today's date. Let me just put a line break and then we start the paragraph tag. Then the curly braces, I put this. So what is going to happen? Nothing is going to happen. Only today's date will get printed. What happens now? It's not saved. See, a long date is showing, correct? And we don't want to show this. We wanted to, you know, format this. So you don't need to bust your head. Tumhe apna dimag lagane ki zarurat nahi. Already there is an inbuilt pipe for it. If I apply a pipe, say I write date pipe. So it will show you the date in this format. Let's say you wanted to change the format. You wanted to have your own format. So you can do that. Colon. DD. MMM. You can define your own format. Yeah, see, correct. So it is totally in my hand. Why it is showing as AUG? Because I put 3x M. If I put 2x capital M, so it will take the regular month. See, is it clear or not?
Yes.
Hello.
Clear.
Yeah.
Yes.
Clear. So you can put any of the format over here. Then we jump on currency. I put HR line again. Of time. Whatever you print, it will print. Obviously, of course, no big deal. Now let's add a currency pipe over here. What is the spelling of currency?
C U double R.
We just apply currency. How does it look like? Yeah, you can say by default dollar, you know, currency is written with dot dot.
Sorry, by dot.
Decimal place, two decimal places written. But the same thing, if I after currency, if you pass ENR, if you write this three digit codes, see, it is giving you rupees 500. Understood? So by passing the country code, you can get the exact currency. EUR. EUR is for Europe. See? Euro symbol. So like this, you can put countries, you know, short codes, and you can apply the currency. Any question, any doubt in this? No, all good.
Yes.
So what these pipes are doing?
Changing our data.
Manipulate data. Data transformation. Okay, team.
Yes. Sir.
Okay, sir.
Good. So we are done with currency, we are done with what do you call it? Date format, we're done with uppercase, lowercase. What else? Okay, wait a minute. Next we see slice. Okay. Let me just grab some water, team. Just coming in 2 minutes. Let me just grab some water.
Hi team, I'm back. Is my voice audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we are done with date pipe. We are done with currency pipe. We are done with uppercase, lowercase. Okay, what else? We'll see how we can filter the array, correct? Say let me have an array in names. Let's say I put some names. Let me put some more names. Yes, this should be good enough. I added a few names, right? And now I wanted to print it. So yesterday only we did this exercise. What are we supposed to do? I wanted to print names. What I should do? I wanted to print an array. Array, what I should do?
Sir, ng4.
Loop. I need to bring loop into picture. Loop. So I have, yes, I sir. Have ng4 directive. I have ng4. Directive. So for I is an iterator that I of names. Right, team? Agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. Okay. And then let's print. Okay, TS is not saved. I saved it. You see, all names got printed, right? Now, I wanted to dynamically slice it. Although it is still hard-coded, I'll show you later how we can pass the dynamic value, but let's see as of now. But it is not hard coded on the HTML from the backend only, code behind file only we are changing. So let's say okay. Slice. Oh. Okay. So I pass two arguments in the slice pipe, 0 and 5. What does that mean? It means that from 0 position till 5th position, correct slice, take a slice. Rest all will be, the moment I save, rest all will be removed. See? 0 to 5. Is it fine, team? Did you understand?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, let's say I say 5 or 4 to 7. See? From 4th position till 7th position, whatever we have, it's sliced. Okay? Correct him?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So these pipes will be handy when you will actually do the binding. Okay, so because these pipes work on the transformation of data. Now, let's say, you know, we wanted a functionality, but we don't have the inbuilt directive and inbuilt pipe. What we should do in that case? Team, question to you. If let's say we don't have the inbuilt inbuilt pipe or inbuilt directive, what we should do? For example, I want to do sorting. I have a grid. I want to do sorting. I want to do filtration, search. So for sorting, searching, we don't have the pipe. What I should do in that case? What I can do in that case?
Sir, we will do it manually.
We call it custom directive. We'll create our own. We will create our own. We will create our own, right? So we call it custom pipe. We call it custom pipe. We call it, what we call it? Custom pipe. Why custom pipe? Because this is the functionality which we are creating. It is not there as inbuilt, we are creating it. So it's a customized information. It's a customized coding, right? Angular has not given, but we are, you know, creating the custom pipe. So that is the beauty of framework. Angular is a framework. Remember I told you in the definition, it gives option to extend the functionality. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So in Angular, basically we can create our own custom directive as well as pipes. But directive also same. I mean, we can create any custom directive for our custom functionality. Is that clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Custom directive is advanced topic. So custom directive, custom pipe, we'll do a little later, not now. What else? I guess in pipes, it's good enough. Let's start the injectable service. So again, this is a new topic and, you know, a big topic. Big topic in the sense is a very important topic. It is one of the advanced topic, but still it is very important. So you want me to start now? Or you want me to start in the next session?
So we can take introduction of it.
Others?
Yes, yeah. Introduction.
Okay. So let's do an introduction of services. I say Angular architecture diagram. Okay. So see, this is a service I was talking about. This is a service. What a service will do? Service one, it holds your business logic. Can you tell me what is business logic?
Any simplest example is fine.
Sir, business logic like sir, bank account, like we are depositing, deposing amount and.
I would say take two input and process it and return the output. Can we say business logic? Can we say business logic? Okay, let me give you a real-time example. You put your card plus PIN, and in return you get money. Isn't it business logic?
Yes, sir.
Correct. You pass your login and password. Okay. In return, you get your landing page. Correct? Of your application. If it is Facebook, then Facebook page. If it is Gmail, then you know your mail page. Is that correct or not? All these things are business logic or not? Correct? So it holds, basically service holds business logic. Okay? Second work, what you know service does is it set up async call, means asynchronous call to your API. Who will call API in Angular? The service will call API, correct, in Angular. The service will have API call, correct? The service will have the API call for you. So where are you going to write the logic to, you know, have an API call or to hit an API? It's your service. Correct. If you have a login service, so your if you have a login API, I mean to say, if you have a login API and you wanted to connect in Angular, you need to put your login service. Then only your login service, or then only your service, whatever name you wanted to give, you can give. Then only your service will be able to hit your login API. Correct. So if you want, I'm repeating one more time. If you wanted to hit the API, you need to have a service. So there are two important work of service. First, it holds the business logic. Second, basically, we use, you know, service to call API. Is this clear to all of you? Is it clear to
yes,
all of
sir.
You?
Yes,
and
sir.
How it works is your component will receive username.
So what is the role of API here?
I'm coming to problem. So your component will receive leave API. No? API is not a part of this discussion. So we'll discuss when we create API or when we use API. As of now, focus here first of all. Huh? So your component will receive username and password. Is that yes or no? I've been telling this one from very long now, like in the event binding, right? We have HTML, we have code behind file, TS file, texture file, which is a class file, correct? Get together both, you know, create a component, right? Yes or no? That is a definition of
yes,
component,
yes.
You know, correct. So with the help of, let's say, event binding, from your login HTML page, your username and password will be posted to your code behind file, which is your class file. Correct?
Yes, sir.
No, I don't think you understood what I said. I'm saying with the help of event binding, your HTML will throw your username and password to the code behind file, right?
say your Java file, your C# file, your PHP file, your TS file, code behind file, remember? Which is class basically. So there you will find username pass. Now component will not call API. API is like application programming interface, which is going to pass the data to DB or retrieve the data from DB. Correct? API is the one, it's a middle layer basically. API is a middleware, middle layer, which takes the input from, you know, your front end and pass it on to DB, or take the information from DB and pass it on to your front end. Correct? So now username and password will be given from HTML to component. Now component will not set up an API call. Component will call service. And what will happen? This username and password from component will go to service. Understood? Now what service will do?
This will pass it to API.
Correct. Service let's will.
Let's see. This is API. And this is database. I wanted to show you the full picture. So now service will pass the username and password to login API, which is a third party thing. This API has nothing to do with Angular. That is why our last layer of code is service. After the service, we have no control, because this API can be built in PHP. Your API can be in .NET. Your API can be in Express.js, which we are going to make. Your API can be in Java. Your API can be in any format, correct? In any technology. Correct, team? So from service, your login credential will go to login API. And then login API will hit the database and pass this username and password. Here, the processing will happen. Correct? Processing will happen. And finally, database will return correct username password. Correct username password. Now API will return back to service that username and password is correct. Now once service receive correct username password, login successful. So now service will throw back the message to component, right? That correct username password. Aur yahan se kyunki ab login credential sahi hai, to yahan se aap kuch bhi bind karo, chahe message bind karo, chahe redirect karo, to aap jo component hai, that will push the response back to HTML saying that correct username and password or incorrect username and password. Is the correct team understood?
Yes.
Is that clear to all of you? This is the full picture of any project. Yeah, go ahead. Ask your question.
I was just asking, sir, what is the role of API then?
API is the middleware basically. API connects your front end and database. Long story short, API is a middleware between your front end and database. If you don't have API, your front end cannot talk to database directly. Understood?
Yes.
Right. I'll explain it in a broader manner when we start the APIs. As of now, this much information is good enough. So you understood the role of service?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The service will take the data, take the input from component, pass it on to API, and receive the information from API and pass it on to component. Okay. Correct, team?
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
I guess that's it for the introduction, right? In the next session, we actually do the hands-on on service. Service, we also call it injector or injectable. Okay.
Clear it?
Then starting by you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then if all done, then let's close the session. I'll see you in the next one. And yes, I will definitely give you the recording of last session and today's session. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Well.